Never in a million years did I think I was going to become a YouTuber. I never imagined that uploading content to this platform every single week would be something that would, one, make me money, and two, would offer value to people all over the world. And first off, I just want to say thank you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart to all of you that subscribe to my channel, that watch my content every single week, and those of you that just find a video or two of mine that happens to be helpful for you. Thank you. I appreciate your support, the comments that you make, the feedback that you give me, and I'm just glad that I'm able to help people all over the world, and it costs you nothing here to watch my content on YouTube other than the ads. So thank you. If this is our first time meeting, hi, I'm Ashlee Espinosa, and here on my YouTube channel, I have been creating content consistently every single week, almost every single week, for the past year. And I went from less than 50 subscribers to over 10,000 in a year. And the only way that I got those first 50 subscribers is because 2 years ago, I took a risk and I wanted to help actors like myself, actors that I was even teaching at the college level, folks that couldn't get to college or didn't want to take college. And I started Captions for Actors, which is, I'm still adding to it, which is a series that gives actors daily inspiration, tips, and actions to put into their weekly routine, into their career, to answer questions that maybe they just didn't know, questions I get in my studio all of the time. And I started that series, and I still had like less than 50 subscribers a couple of years ago. And one regret that I have as a YouTuber is I wish that I had continued that series. I think I did it for like 3 months, and I posted every single week, and I did what you're seeing now is the full production value. I tried out different backdrops. I tried to give valuable information. I was really focused on content that was timely, which now I know as a YouTuber that it's really better to sprinkle content in that's evergreen and timely, and make sure that, consider the idea that people could be watching this video, you know, years from now. So that's the one regret I have, because I wish I had kept up doing Captions for Actors. So last year, about a year ago from when I'm posting this video right now, was when everyone had to jump online. And I had all of these colleagues and friends say, hey, I know you've been teaching online at the college level for like over 5 years now. Help me, please. And I have always been using Canvas at the colleges that I've been at. And even for my classes that aren't online, even for the classes that are synchronous, face-to-face, and don't even have really an online component of any sorts, I still use Canvas. And the reason why is because there are a lot of other things that are helpful for you and for the students. And so I was very familiar with the platform. And I was creating tutorials for my colleagues and just sending them to them. And they were like, oh, can I send it to, you know, my other faculty members? And I was like, yeah, go for it. If it's helpful, sure. And so I started uploading them to YouTube. And then I just started making them public because I don't know, why not? And it kind of caught on like wildfire. And the thing I really want people to understand is this platform is free. It costs me nothing to upload my content. Now, do I pay for a lot of other bells and whistles? Yes, absolutely now. But I just wanted to help people. And now I get messages from people all over the world. And I thought, well, if it helps people, great. Now, not only do I want to help people, but because I'm monetized here on YouTube, I actually make an income. It's not a ton of money, but it's a great way to make income for me. So it helps me continue to make more videos. And I know that a lot of us here on YouTube are like, oh, we do it because we love, you know, the value we offer. And yes, that's absolutely true. But it takes me a lot of time, and it's taken me money to invest in equipment, in, you know, subscriptions, to make sure that I do everything copyright legal. And it takes me a lot of time and energy. And so the fact that I can now monetize by the ads that you're watching helps me continue to create content on this channel, make it available to you. The first point about being on YouTube that I want to let you know, whether you want to be on YouTube or you're just watching my content because you enjoy seeing my content, is there's a lot of fear that comes with uploading a video. even right now, I'm like, this week I'm gonna upload a video that is totally different than I normally do. Less teaching, more emotional based, and just connecting a little bit more, being a little bit more real and authentic with my experience here on this platform. And fear is the biggest one. Fear of uploading a video that someone's gonna say something. And I've had negative comments, and that just kind of comes with the territory. Fear that no one's gonna watch the video. When I sit there and watch the counts and it's like 50 people, 100 people, and it stays for a little bit, and then you're like, oh no, that video sucked. And it's just the algorithm didn't pick it up, it didn't resonate with people for whatever reason, and that's okay. So fear has been a big factor that I've had to overcome to continue to put myself on camera every single week, but it's absolutely worth it. The second part about YouTube that I've really learned is to be consistent. Being consistent is something that's really helped my channel grow, because I upload a new video every week, and every video may not resonate with one subscriber. I have subscribers to my channel that are actors, some that are educators, some that are in the arts, some that do both, that are very much like what I do. But some people just, you know, watch my content for one video. And being consistent really allows me to diversify my audience and help more people. I know a lot of people here on YouTube say, you know, niche down, be very specific and focused, but my entire career has been very broad. You know, I'm a content creator, I'm an educator, I'm a coach, I'm an actor, I'm a singer, I'm a dancer, I'm like, you know, a podcaster, so I do all of these things. And that's kind of just been my experiment, is posting different types of content. It's really attracted different types of audiences. And I'm not here to be a millionaire famous YouTuber, it's not my goal. But it's my goal to reach a broader audience so that I can find ways to help more people. So being consistent, that's the next thing that's really been a learning curve for me. Posting every single week, it's hard. The third part of being a YouTuber that has really affected me to get from less than 50 subscribers to over 10,000, I think I'm like at 11,000 when I'm posting this video, is to be okay with criticism. I get comments on my videos, some that are very negative that I can delete and take into account that it's just not someone's good day maybe, or someone who doesn't like my video. And then it's interesting that I get comments from people that are very critical of how I'm delivering content. And I always respond with a, you know, thanks for letting me know. I'll take that into consideration, and it really has helped me make better videos. Sometimes I used to go up on the end of my lines, and even as an actor, it's still hard to get behind a camera. So I take that feedback that all of you people give me, which is so helpful, and then I can incorporate that into my videos in the future. So that's been something that's been a bit of a learning curve, is to take critiques from people that you don't know from all over the world. So keep learning, keep growing. I just keep in mind that it's all for the best. It's all for the ways for me to provide better value for you. And the last step that I've learned about being a YouTuber to go from less than 50 subscribers to over 10,000 is, do not burn out. I burned out once, and a mini burnout version a second time. And I batch record a lot of my content, sometimes 2 weeks in advance, sometimes a month in advance, it just depends. But burnout happens when you film, create, edit, post on a weekly basis. And that was something I learned very early on, is I had all these people saying, can you create a video about this? Can you create a video about that? And I was like, yes, 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 I'll do all these things. And I had this list that was like 100 videos long that I knew I would never get to. And so I had to tell myself that if I burn out, then I can't keep creating content, and I will be very negative when I do it. It won't be something that I enjoy doing, and thus it won't help anyone on the other side as well. So understanding what works best for me, how much value that I can offer, and when I can't. And I get a lot of folks that reach out to me for one-on-one coaching, and there are many times that I just have to say, I just don't have the availability in my schedule, and everybody's been very understanding. So burnout is real, it happens in whatever job that I'm sure you're in, you understand. And that's something that I've had to learn as a YouTuber, that it's okay to take a break. It's okay to do, you know, a shorter video. It's okay to post something 1 week and the next week say, I don't feel like posting, I'm gonna do, you know, this instead and come back to my subscribers and offer them some other value and content. So that's been a learning curve. All in all, being on YouTube has helped me build my audience. It's helped me build my own income. It's helped me build my studio, my online classes that I'm creating and offering in my membership programs. And it's really helped me connect and reach to people all over the world. So thank you once again for watching my content. I appreciate you. I value you. I see you even though I only get to see you through a camera lens. Please feel free to leave me any comments below, anything that you need from me that I can offer in the future. And again, thank you for helping me get to over 10,000 subscribers. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.